Okay, yes, today we have Queen and Who Wants to Live Forever. You know, with the Queen dying and everything, all of a sudden Queen was requested, and I've been seeing a lot of people react to Queen now. So I thought, why the heck not listen to Who Wants to Live Forever? Obviously, I've heard the song. I think everybody has heard, a lot of Queen songs. But anyway, I've never delved into the lyrics. I've never listened to it with headphones, all this stuff. And also, if you're a returning viewer, there you go. Yeah, I'm at a different. I moved downstairs. I was upstairs. Now I'm downstairs. Things are still, happening. I put some posters up just because. But things are probably gonna move around still. Anyway, I just decided why not. And also, yes, I don't know if I already mentioned, but there's probably an echo, and I apologize. Anyway, let's get into this today. Talk about it after. Let's go. So smooth.
There's no chance for us.
The transition. I mean, just what a huge song. I mean, just inside and out. From the, actually, what I'm looking at here, hold on. I was just looking at the personnel here, and because I wanted to say, the huge drums, and I mean, on Wikipedia anyway, it says on drum machine and backing vocals, of course, Roger Taylor, but also on percussion, the National Philharmonic Orchestra. And I do see on genius.com on their credits that Roger Taylor is not, credited on drums at all. So either way, I mean, the big bangs, all that, continuously, just added to the, I mean, the already huge sound that the song had. I mean, it just sounds so important. It sounds so, just so big. I mean, there's no other way to say it. It's an anthem. Obviously, it's a huge power ballad. And it's just, I mean, the echo, the everything about the song is huge, and it's just like, I don't know, it's such a magnifying listen is what it really comes down to. And I like how also I do know, I think it's on the in the movie, Freddie Mercury sings it all, for the movie that it was in, which was, oh goodness gracious, where is it? Hold on. It was in Highlander. There it is. From 1986. And yeah, so in the movie, Freddie sings it all, but obviously on the album version, and I think on the Greatest Hits version, which are there are three, obviously. There's a three versions there. Brian May sings the first verse, and then like I said during the the song, I like the transition from Brian May to Freddie Mercury. It's just he picks right up where Brian left off, and I mean obviously it's it sounds dumb to say, what else? What can you say about Freddie Mercury that hasn't been said already? I mean, I would say, even as somebody who's not a huge, Queen fan, I'm a fan of Queen, but I'm not like, it's not my favorite band or whatever. But I would still argue that Freddie Mercury is the greatest frontman of all time. I mean, I don't think that's, that's a hot take. I mean, it's Freddie Mercury. I mean, my God. And yeah, he just had obviously the stage presence, the passion, and how the song is written. I mean, I just, I know Brian, also searching out, because searching up about the song and seeing things before getting into it, that Brian May wrote the song because he was going through some things, in his life. I guess he was, it was a failing marriage. His father was, I guess he was, on death's doorstep is basically what I got. And that I guess his marriage and his father died in 1988. That's what Wikipedia is telling me anyway. So anyway, and how he wrote the song, a couple of years before, and he knew all the stuff was going to happen. And how, who goes on about who wants to live forever, and that he saw, part of the movie, and how they were supposed to write a song for the movie. And I mean, that's, and also, there's a lot of information that I've learned here that I'm just spitting out. But how, here it says on Song Facts anyway, Queen was commissioned to write this for the movie Highlander, and Brian May wrote it after watching the first cut of the film. He wrote the line, "Who wants to live forever?" in a cab on his way home from viewing the film. Inspiration from the scene where Connor MacLeod takes his dying wife Heather in his arms at the time of her death. This is also the scene where the song is played. I mean, yeah, and it goes on there. In the film, Freddie Mercury sings the first verse, but on the album, Brian May sings the first verse, and Freddie sings the rest. So anyway, yeah. So like I'm saying, Brian wrote that in the cab, and I mean, it's just in how, like he said, I guess there was another quote that I saw earlier again, but now I can't find it, of course. But how, it just came to him. He doesn't even. Somebody asked, how did he come up with that? And he said he doesn't even know. And I mean, again, that's just, you're gonna have. I mean, he wrote, many good songs for the band, obviously. I mean, Freddie, him, John Deacon, even, they all wrote great songs, and Roger Taylor as well. Get him as, "I Love My Car," whatever that song was. Anyway, I still, listened to that back in the day. Anyway, but yeah, so they were all great songwriters, obviously, and great musicians. And I mean, I wanted to say as well with Brian May's guitar here, he has such a distinct sound. I mean, when it's Brian May, that's just, I don't know if you listen to Queen for so long, I guess. Which I mean, I don't think you can escape them. I mean, they're everywhere. But still to this day. But yeah, he has such a distinct guitar tone, guitar sound, what's Brian May. And also I wanted to say as well, my goodness, that what else did I want to say actually? Who wants to, oh yeah, I was gonna say, how Brian May wrote this about, the people in his life, his own problems. But of course, with Freddie Mercury dying, I think like 5 years later, after 86 and 1991, how a lot of people, how the song became like a big thing, because you know Who Wants to Live Forever, you thought about Freddie, and obviously, I mean, again, the song pops up. It's one of those songs where that you listen to when you lose a loved one, and which is why people requested the song. Why don't you listen to this, because the Queen died, which I mean, I wanted just to listen or just to react to Queen, I never have before, so, or just to, I guess, review a Queen song, which is just neat to do in the first place. But anyway, it's one of those big songs that, you listen to, and I mean, again, if it's at like a funeral or whatever, you're probably going to shed a tear, because it's a huge song, with such emotion. Obviously, the band just captured that emotion. Just, I mean, thank God that the film came along, I guess, and, made them create a song like this. And thank God Brian May was in his feels that day, or, for not just that day, but for a while, I guess. And, like I said, yeah. And then how Freddie would go on to be, diagnosed with HIV AIDS, I think a year later in 87. And, how it just, I mean, the song just fits everything that happened after, his later years, I guess, Freddie's later years from 86 to 91. So anyway, yeah, just a huge song. I mean, my God. I think I've talked about everything right after that, but it's just, I mean, I love the song. As it says here on Wikipedia, it's been performed at many Freddie Mercury tribute concerts and such, which, I mean, well, it was that in the 1992 one, but I think there's been more, maybe not, maybe I'm just dumb. And how it's been placed, Rolling Stone placed it as their fifth favorite Queen song, so take that for what it is. And also it says it was listed at number 15 on the top 20 Queen songs of all time by Smooth Radio. So there you go. Anyway, I don't think there's too much else I really need to say. I mean, I think I've said it all. Who Wants to Live Forever? I mean, I do usually read the about on Genius. Let me just see here, actually. Who Wants to Live Forever was composed by Brian May. Brian May, good Lord, and sung on the album version as a duet between he and Freddie Mercury. Synth parts are played on a Yamaha DX7 by May, and the orchestra was arranged by and conducted by Michael Kamen, I want to say. John Deacon did not participate on the original recording, but the video features him playing a white double bass, and Roger Taylor played some drum machine parts and contributed backing vocals. And again, Roger Taylor's vocals, I gotta say, he's very underrated. Obviously, I mean, if you've seen the movie Bohemian Rhapsody, you see, or, when there's that part where he's doing the high notes for the song Bohemian Rhapsody, he was such a, he's a great tenor, obviously. He has such a great voice, and he's still alive, I mean, but I don't think his voice would be as good as it was, like it was, 4 years ago. Anyway, it goes on, the percussion was taken over by the orchestra, as well as the bass. Okay, so there it is, basically the orchestra kind of took over from Deacon and Taylor. It serves as somewhat of a love theme of Highlander, as it adds to the subplot of the movie. Mercury sings the first verse as well, unlike the album version, which may sing it for where he sings first, like I already said. Anyway, so yeah, like it says there, I forgot to even talk about John Deacon. Yeah, he wasn't even on the recording here, but I guess he shows up in the video. And I mean, I was not going to try to do, react to the video, because I would imagine a Queen music video would probably get me blocked. Probably I wouldn't be able to upload that because of restrictions and all this stuff. So I figured, why not just do, the song. So anyway, all that said, great song. I mean, I don't feel like you need me to tell you. I mean, obviously, like I said, played at many, important events and all this stuff, because it's such a big emotional tune and power ballad, like I said. And, I mean, what else can you say? I mean, Freddie, it's a friggin' Queen song. It's Freddie Mercury singing his heart out, with Brian May also pouring his heart out with the lyrics and, his first verse. So anyway, that's all I gotta say. Thanks for, my God, thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. And again, I gotta get this room in shape. I got a lot of things here. Like I said, just moved. And, but I have to still upload. I mean, my goodness. So anyway, thanks again for watching, all the support. I'll talk to you guys again soon.